Hey guys, what's going on? So today is going to be another weekly grind video. So let's go ahead and jump into it. This is going to be for the global side of Dokkan Battle. So first up is Dragon Ball Super Universe 6 Saga. This is running until 1/25/2018. So you have some time. You have about 15 days, almost 2 weeks left before this actually goes away. You have some time to grind it out. You could actually transcend Whis by getting the Champa and the Vados medals. He Dokkan Awakens. He's a pretty cool unit when he Dokkan Awakens. He disables enemies' guard too, which makes him pretty damn cool for an extreme intelligence team. Not a primary unit you would want to run, but you can definitely run. He definitely gets a lot more useful when he gets Dokkan Awakened. His attack was up by 80%. Like a lot of the other extreme intelligence type characters, he doesn't have a lot of good links when it comes to ki, but he'll at least be doing some decent damage. You also have the farmable Kaba, which you can go ahead and grab if you would like to. He's a cool free unit to get from the game. He can get up to, it would do super attack 10 with him, and he's good for an actual technique team. His passive skill attack plus 50% isn't great for like a primary team, but when you're running up against prime battles, he can be useful for you. The Vados medals are on stage 2. The actual Kabas are available from stage 6, and Champa medals are from stage 8, and Dokkan Awakened medals for the Kaba is for the Vegetas is from stage 7. So you'll need Vegeta, Vados, and Champa medals to Dokkan Awaken him. Outside of that event period, again, that's about it. Yeah, that's it. You get a Dragonstone per stage. You get some cool training items on stage 5 if you want to. Outside of that, I guess you get some Dendes from stage 4. That would be cool. That's kind of noteworthy, I guess, just because it's a healing item in case you guys don't have them. I know you guys are probably overloaded on Sensu Beans if you've been playing for a while. The next one is going to be Fight Against Despair is now on. That runs until the 17th. You get the Gohan, not really a good unit. You get the Trunks, who Dokkan Awakens into Super Saiyan Trunks. This one is pretty cool unit. He gets a second Dokkan Awakening. I don't know have the date. I don't believe he has his second Dokkan Awakening as of yet, just because it's not here in the notes. But he will. I definitely recommend getting with the Super Tech 10. And if you like this free-to-play Trunks, if you're aware of him on the JP side, get the obviously the 4 Dupaz unlocked after you Dokkan Awaken him. So that way, when you do Dokkan Awaken him, you could actually make him hit harder. When he Dokkan Awakens a second time, he will get Supreme Damage, which makes him a really good free-to-play unit. You could also Dokkan Awaken the future Gohan if you were able to summon him. This is a summonable only unit. He does not Dokkan Awaken from this guy over here, so the only way to get him is to get him on a summon. He Dokkan Awakens with his own medal from the Fight Against Despair event. That is going to be from stage 4 for the Gohan medals. The Android medals are on stage 6. They're a pain in the butt to grab. Stage 7 is Vegeta. I believe that the Androids are only because they have different drop. Like, they have the same exact drop rate, but trying to get the one that you want is a pain in the butt. Outside of that, you will need to, for the last ones, if you want to get like Icaruses, you're going to need to run either Trunks or Gohan on the stage in order to grab Icarus. The Bulma item is really good. You're going to need to have this Trunks Dokkan Awaken in order to get her and to actually go through the stage. And stage 10, you're going to need to have at least one Gohan on your team in order to get the Android 18s. If you just want to get it for the Dragon Stones, you're going to need him anyway. So if you don't really care about the Gohan, but you're going to actually need him to get through stage 10 to get the Dragon Stones. But outside of that, that's it for this one. This one, again, runs until the 17th, so you have 7 days, so you have 1 week until this event goes away, and then it'll come back probably in another month, because this one always comes back. The next one is going to be the new stage of Ultimate Awakened. So this is the Ultimate Gohan one. This is the Ultimate Gohan event is open for 3 more days. I'm really hoping we get the Super Saiyan Bardock, but I'm pretty sure I read somewhere that the Revival Warrior category has been translated. And I have about 450 stones. As much as I want the Super Saiyan 4 Bardock, I really like the prospect of having a revival team. So I might do some summons with you guys on that revival team. Hopefully I can get Frieza. But anyway, this one runs until the 13th, so we should know. Let's see, the 13th is what? On Saturday. So that means Sunday we should either have a new Dokkan event, or we'll have at least information as to it coming on Thursday. It's usually what happens. It's either Sunday nights or Thursday nights. I'm hoping for Sunday night myself, but we'll see what happens. The event is running. You can go ahead. It's the same exact medals between Stage 1, Stage, or Super Z-Hard and Super 2. It's the Elder Kai ones. It's up to the second stage. It allows you to get 7-in-1 drop, which is really cool. Makes it easier, especially if you're doing some grinding. Passive skill, Wall Standing Tall from the Booze is going to help you defeat this Gohan. You don't really need them, honestly, if you have an OP team. Like, if you have a Fusions team, it's definitely not going to be a requirement for you to use them. But you can, it'll definitely make it easier, especially if you have, like, let's say, a Rose lead and you have all extreme, you can throw a whole bunch of booze on there and just destroy him. But, yeah, that's up to you on how you want to run the event. I haven't done a team building guide on this. I don't think it really warrants one, but if you guys need one, let me know. I'll tell you right now, probably the best thing you could do is if you have the physical Korra, you could bring all these freaking different booze on your team and do a physical event. I mean, yeah, he is a strength type, but they do heal, so that might help you out a little bit. The other one would probably be, I believe it was, what's the other one? Intelligence, right? Because you have the Kid Buu lead. So you would have Kid Buu, you would have, I don't think, you would have, yeah, I think that's it. I don't think Buhan's on here. No, wow, okay, so Buhan doesn't have Wall Standing Tall. So it would be Kid Buu and this Buu over here would be your two primary units, and you'd want to bring other intelligence units. But, I mean, having Janemba and another Kid Buu would probably be a really good setup for you anyway. But, anyway, outside of that, this is a decent event. It's not that hard. You're going to Doken Awaken your Strength Ultimate Gohan here. This is the Hybrid Saiyan lead. The Intelligence Gohan, if you want to Doken Awaken him. I don't know what he's going to be when he gets his Extreme Z Awakening. We'll have to wait and see to find out. But he should, when he gets his, we'll know how good he's going to be. Right now, his passive skill is Ki plus 5 and Attack plus 10,000. I don't know if he's going to get a flat-out buff or not. Maybe he'll get, like, a flat-out buff of attack plus 100,000 or something like that. Or maybe they'll just change a 2% buff, you know what I mean? That would be great. But that would be cool. We'll see what happens with that. We also have the agility one, if you guys are into that kind of thing. I'm not a big fan of the agility one, but you Doken Awaken him for these medals. And the physical one, the OG one, that used to be really good because he was essentially Gogeta without the attack buff back in the day, anyway. So he was pretty cool. He's not really useful anymore, but you can Doken Awaken him from this event as well. A whole bunch of Ultimate Gohans here. Again, 3 more days left for this to be Varon Daily. When it comes back, I believe it's only back on Intelligence and Strength Days and Hero Days, so 3 days a week. So you do have a long period of time in which you can grind it out. Next one is the Tree of Might event. Now, I know I've talked about this one a lot. This ends in 3 days. Oh man, I never could stop talking about this one. You get the Turles medals here to Doken Awaken your Turles. Definitely recommend doing that, but before you Doken Awaken him, I recommend grinding out the other Turleses here and Z-Awakening them for a 50% chance to increase his super attack. The same thing goes for the Technique one. Technique one is available from the World Tournament summons. This Intelligence one is only available from regular summons. So if you got him, get him with the Super Attack 10 before you Doken Awaken him. Highly recommend getting the Super Attack 10 because it's really obtainable. You also have this guy over here. What's his name again? Days is over here. He's not really that great. You never really use him. And the only really good thing about this event is that the Turles is farmable. the good thing is when you go and farm the Turles will obviously give you attack plus, a super attack increased chance. But if you're grinding the event with the level where you get all the medals, those medals are essentially all Baba fodder, and you can get a lot. I think I got, like, I forgot how much. I got, like, over 1,000 Baba points. Easily, I think it was probably more like, yeah, it was probably about 1,000 to 1,500 Baba points just from grinding out the event trying to get the Turleses, and then you have to go and get the medals. So definitely worth it because you can grind out a lot of Baba points. You can get your Turleses again with the Super Attack 10. The other thing to note from this event is the Icarus, really good for defense reduction. I use it all the time if you guys watch my videos on really hard events. The other one is the Fruit of the Tree of Might, which you definitely want to grind out because it's Ki plus 3 for all allies for 3 turns. Very useful in like prime battle and things like that where you need a Ki buff for a short period of time. It could last you about 6 rounds total, or you just do 3 rounds for Ki plus 6 if you're a brand new player. That'll probably help you out if you don't have a good leader. Outside of that, that's about it. I would definitely recommend grinding this out for the Turleses if you have him. If you don't have him, at least get some Icaruses and Fruit of the Tree of Might for yourself. Next one is going to be the Warriors of Universe 6 summons. It's running until the 21st. Now, I myself am not summoning on this. I kind of want to because it's discounted summons in GSSR. But, like, I don't need it. I have this Goku, I have Frieza, I have Khalifa, and I have Kale. There's no reason for me to actually, I don't think I have Kale on the global side. It doesn't matter, I don't really want her. Even if I do, I forgot if I had her or not. But either way, I don't really want her because I'm never going to use her. Either way, this is a good banner if you don't have any of these guys. Frieza is really good for tanking. Highly recommend getting him if you don't have him. He's going to come in really handy on a revived warrior team when you're going up, if you're trying to extreme Z-Awaken your Super Saiyan 3 Angel Goku, because he will be able to tank everything if you don't have the Technique Frieza. If you do have the Technique Frieza, then you're not going to need him. He is also going to serve as a decent linking buddy for the revived Golden Frieza, the one with the Angel. That should be coming up in a couple of days. Khalifa is still a really good unit. She's really also good for the Peppy Gals category lead. So you can definitely run her as a leader if you want to. She'll help you out when you're going on against the Master Roshi event. And Kale is just kind of there. She's like essentially a mini Broly, and everyone kind of hates Broly. Outside of that, this Goku's really good. He's better than the Kaioken Blue Goku, and he could be a really good unit on your team if you have all 4 Dupes unlocked. So you can go ahead and do that. Plus, he Doken Awakens, I believe, with the Kaioken Blue Goku medals. So I have mine Super Attack 10 with all 4 Dupes unlocked. I'm just kind of waiting for the dupe system thing to come out so I can get most of them filled out. This Whis is also really good at stunning, so Overall, this is not a bad banner. I'm not going to lie to you. I don't think this is a bad banner at all. Personally, I'm not going to summon on it. If you guys don't have any of these characters, it really wouldn't hurt you because these are good units to have on your team. You know, they're not A tier, or I'm sorry, they're not S tier, they're A tier. Like, they're units that, like, you can use in specific situations, or if you don't have a lot of good units, they're definitely going to be units you're going to want in place of the best units in-game. Next one is going to be the Hybrid Saiyan banner. This runs until the 17th. One more week left for this one. This one actually has really good units on it. These are the prime units that you would want. This Gohan's really good when he Dokkan Awakens. You would definitely want to get him because he's really good for a super physical team. So if you have a super physical team going on with the Super Saiyan 3 Gotenks, he's definitely going to be a primary unit for you. You're definitely going to run him for support. This Goten, you're going to run him every once in a while. And this Trunks, you're going to run every once in a while as well. I like this Trunks because he's going to be really good, like, going up against any type of Battle Road or anything like that when you're going up against straight agility units, because damage received reduced by 40%, and he gives himself a flat-out attack buff of 80%. Plus, you have to remember, Goten and Trunks are all semi-farmable because there's a lot of SR drops. I think each of these have two separate SRs that are Super Saiyans that you can feed in when you Z-Awaken for a 50% chance to increase their super attack. So getting Goten and Trunks really aren't that bad, especially when you have units like these. They're definitely worth it. Attack plus 80% on both of them, plus chance to reduce damage on with Goten on any from anyone, and Trunks just reduces from everyone. It's really good, really good units. That's all I have to say about that. You also have a whole bunch of other decent units that are on here. I'm not going to go over every single one of them. If you guys don't have any Hybrid Saiyans, if you pull the Ultimate Gohan and you don't have a lot of good Hybrid Saiyans, this banner might be for you. It's pretty good. It looks like it is going to be all featured characters are the Hybrid Saiyans category. I don't think it's any guaranteed SSRs here. It doesn't say GSSR, so it's up to you if you want to summon on it. I think discounted banners are definitely worth it for the free-to-play player. But, you know, you might want to wait for a GSSR banner like this one over here. It's up to you, though, how you guys want to handle it. It's a good banner, I think. It's an overall decent banner. Just from seeing over here, like, I don't like Future Gohan, but this Gohan over here, the Super Saiyan 2 one, if you don't have the LR Gohan, he's definitely a decent unit as well. The Dokkan Festival runs until the 13th, guys, so you have the available to pull on this summon, this banner as well. Honestly, I haven't summoned on this banner, and I'm looking at it, and I kind of want to pull on it. Because I wouldn't mind a dupe Janemba. I only have two dupes of this Vegeta. I don't have this Trunks, and I don't have this Gohan. Banner might be kind of worth it for me. It's the 13th. I want to find out what's coming with that Revive Warrior. And obviously, I don't have this Boo. So, there are some cool units over here. We'll see what happens. I don't think I'm going to do summons on this banner, but maybe at some point, maybe I'll try, like, one multi-summon or something like that on live stream if I do a live stream tomorrow night. Anyway, this runs until the 13th. A decent banner, especially if you like the Hybrid Saiyans team. Go for it if you want to. Personally, I'm not going to make a huge deal out of it, but maybe I will. We'll see what happens. Let's see. The next one is going to be Christmas Ticket Summons. That runs until the 13th as well if you guys have your leftover summons from the Ultra Instinct Goku banner. This is going to be ending soon in 3 days. So if you guys have any leftover tickets, please make sure to go and use them because once this is gone, you won't be able to use them again. After 5 summons, you get GSSR. Personally, I didn't get the two that I wanted, but I got this guy, which is really cool because now I have all 4 dupe pads unlocked of him. It runs until the 13th, guys. Make sure to grab them, use them when you can. Anyway, going over to the JP side now, we're almost done. We're going to wrap this up real quick. It looks like we have the 29th. It's just going to be the Tarble event. Tarble is farmable from Stage 2. You get the Dokkan Awakened medals from Stage 3. And you get the base form Gotenkses on Stage 4. You can feed them into the other base form Gotenkses if you want to. The strength one and the agility one before you Dokkan Awaken them. I highly recommend doing that. Plus, he's not a bad unit. He's a free-to-play unit. Tarble Dokkan Awaken is really not that great. You can do it if you want to. And I guess you get his wife, and his wife doesn't really do that much. She's not a really good support item in-game. Overall, that's about it. Runs until the 29th. Go ahead and grind out those Gotenks. That's really what all this event is really for. Gotenks. Oh, and I guess the Radishes I should mention. Radishes, you're going to grind from Stage 1, and you go into the Baba Shop, and you purchase items from them. You can do that grind if you want to. It runs until the 29th. You have almost a full month, to the end of the month, to do this. Next one is going to be the Future Trunks event from Dragon Ball Super. Runs until the 18th. You have 8 more days for this. Notable things is going to be Trunks medals on Stage 6 and Super Saiyan Trunks and Vegeta medals on Stage 7. And you have base form Trunkses on Stage 4, which Dokkan Awaken into Super Saiyan Trunks. So you can go ahead and grind them out if you like to. You also get the medals to Dokkan Awaken your physical Trunks from, well, his base form to this guy. He's a really good support unit as well for all allies. So him and that Gohan are both really good support units that I had mentioned earlier. And Vegeta can Dokkan Awaken. No one really uses this guy, though. You can Dokkan Awaken him, but no one really uses him. But I am a Vegeta fan. I still don't find this card that useful. But yeah, that's what all this is available from. Vegeta Doken Awakens with his own medals. Trunks Doken Awakens with his own medals. And the free-to-play unit is farmable from all three different units. So, or all three different medals. So stage 6 and 7 would be a lot of grind. Outside of that, runs until the 18th, guys. Go ahead and grind it out if you want to. Next one is going to be the Super Vegito event. That one runs until the 31st, it looks like. Oh, 2030. Okay. So this just means this was added. That's all that there is to it. So he's going to be available. I don't really need to talk about it. It just says that this was added. This one, same thing with the Rose one. So this one is going to be available, I believe, on Tech Days and Physical Days and Hero Days. He's going to be available on Agility, Strength, and Villain Days. And that's about it. The banner looks like it runs until the 18th, so you have 8 more days to summon on it. This is both banners, actually, Dual Dokkan Fest. Really good banners I pulled on it. Unfortunately, I didn't get what I wanted, but I got some decent units. It wasn't horrible for me. I would really like that Rose. I really like Rose. This artwork is freaking phenomenal, in my opinion. Really do enjoy it. But anyway, nice setup, nice banner, runs until the 18th. If you guys like those units, pull on them. If you're free to play, it's up to you. Last but not least, we have the Elder Kai running until the 18th, 8 more days, so I did one summon on this. I'm probably going to see if I already have 25 stones just from logging in. I might grind out some levels and quests just to get the rest of the 25 so I can do one more summon on it. But yeah, that runs until the 18th as well. Elder Kai banner's always worth it, in my opinion. But anyway, guys, that's it. Thank you for joining me here today. I again want to apologize for, being kind of ghost for the past, week. So, most of the stuff is taken care of last night, as I had said. I still have a couple more things to finish up, but most of the stuff that I want to do has been taken care of. But anyway, guys, thank you for joining me here today. I'll catch you guys tomorrow. You all have a great day. Peace.